going on, man? It's your boy Torae, live from Brooklyn, New York. I'm in the pen right now, and you tuned in to ArtofRhyme.com. That's what it is.
You know what it is. You know what it is.
Yo, we 2 days away, June 2nd, cop the record, double barrel, 14 joints for the intro. Intro by DJ Premier, cuts by DJ Link, DJ Revolution, and Shiloh. Features by Master Ace, Sean Price, Lil Fame from M.O.P., Rock from Helter Skelter, who else on the album? I want Guilty Simpson, shout out to the D, Socrates, S-Rock from Canada, so, you know, and I'm on it too, so, album is banging, man, I'm not just saying that because I'm a part of it, like, the critical acclaim it's been getting from the people who reviewed it, the records we leaked have been received really well. I just got word that we got an XL in the new Double XL magazine, so I'm feeling real good about that. I haven't seen it yet. But, you know, I mean, everything is just moving in the right direction. It feels good. You know what? I actually try to pride myself on working out one thing at a time. Yeah, I like to stay busy, of course, but I also like to really dive into my work, you know what I'm saying? So I try to divulge and submerge myself fully in one project at a time with that one focus, just so I'm not all over the place, like scatterbrained. Like, because this project, and when you hear it, you'll understand why I can really only focus on this. Because this is unlike anything else I've ever done, like with the delivery and the beats and the way I'm attacking the records. I couldn't do this and another project. It just wouldn't lend itself to doing something else. So I really try to work on one thing at a time. You know, so the whole focus right now is Marco Polo on Torae, Double Barrel, Duck Down Records, June 2nd. Make sure you pick it up. See, Marco and I are going to work as long as we both here on Earth. You know, Lord willing, we're going to work because that's the homie. You know what I'm saying? Like, we both real like-minded with the music. You know what I'm saying? He know what he like, I know what I like, and we work well together. Well, you know, I mean, I'm a grinder. I'm a grinderholic. So with or without the deal, I'll try to stay on the road and try to stay working, doing shows. But definitely since the Duck Down situation, you know, they've been able to assist with a few shows and the relationships I had, I've been able to knock out a few shows. So we moving, man. We doing the big hip-hop festival in Brooklyn, which I'm looking forward to rocking in my hometown. A lot of people usually come out to that. We got a tribute to the classic show with Black Moon and Swift Western tomorrow. Marco and I opening that up. I just actually rocked with The Roots on Tuesday of this week, which was a crazy, serious experience. You know, and a lot of other shit, man. We're working on a European tour, trying to get out to hip-hop camp out in Czech Republic and all that. So, you know, we working, man. We moving, you know. If you don't work, you don't eat, and I like to eat. So, gotta put that work in.
You had a song, you had a track, Switch, right?
Right.
And so, can you give us a little bit, for people that might not have heard it, can you give a little background as to maybe why you did it and what it is?
When you put records on the internet, the beautiful thing about that is that you get instant feedback. And a lot of times in the comments, people be like, yo, Tor is dope, but I like Tor. And of course, you get people that don't like it. And it's like, yo, I don't like his delivery. It's too one-dimensional. I don't like his voice. It's monotone, this and this and that. So what I decided to do on the Switch record was just switch it up. Like, every four bars, I switched the style. It was dope to hear the people's interpretations of what I was doing. Some people thought I was just doing different rapping styles. Some people thought I was doing different regions. I was actually doing a lot of a whole bunch of different shit, just like whatever came to mind, whatever felt good, I switched it up. But it was ill to hear what people thought. Like, people thought I was mocking 50 and like Eminem and just all types of stuff I heard. So it's always crazy to hear what you know, what you got in your mind, and then hear what the people's interpretation of it is. So, and the Switch record actually did real well for me. You know, we put out a digital 12, which sold really well. And shout out to Black Milk on the beat. It was dope. It was a real dope record. Support the music, support hip-hop, come out to the shows. If you love hip-hop music, if you hear something and it does something to you, puts you in a certain zone, a certain space, support it, support the artists. That's how to keep the art form alive. Come to the shows, buy merch, you know what I'm saying? $13, $14 to you at the end of the day, once you blow it, it's nothing. To artists, 10, 20,000 of y'all do it, it makes a career. So just make sure you get out there and support. I see a lot of dudes, you know what I'm saying? I'm fortunate, like I'm current and I'm popping right now, whatever. I see a lot of dudes, like, you know, really trying to get it in and really struggling. So just make sure if you fuck with the music, and only if you fuck with it, if it's bullshit, don't even deal with it. But if you fuck with the music and you really into it, show that artist some love and support. You know what I mean? 99 cents on the download single. You know what I mean? It all means something. That's what it is. June 2nd, Double Barrel in stores. Shout out to Drew High Buck. Shout out to the whole Duck Down staff. Shout out to ArtofRhyme for having me. Shout out to Boston. Shout out to Harper, Ferry. I'm about to go in there and blow the motherfucking roof off. Ow!
Causing damage with words. Witnesses of the nouns, metaphors, and verbs.